I think if China had their wish, they'd wait till after the election. They'll pray that Trump loses, and then they'll make a deal with a stiff, somebody that doesn't know what they're doing, like Obama and Biden, like all of the presidents before, because what they've done is they've just picked our pockets as a nation. That's not happening with Trump.
Did he just say make a deal with a stiff? The control room's telling me yes. That was the president today putting China on notice as trade talks resume in Shanghai. He says China should make a deal now because if they wait, well, they're going to have to make a deal with a stiff. But that aside, if he's the one that's reelected, well, the deal's going to be that much tougher for the Chinese. So they'd be smarter to just get it over with and do the right thing.
How much is this costing China? I mean, I've been looking at their numbers and they're actually, you know, and look, it's not great for us. I get it. Like, we, you know, but that said, you either deal with it like now or you're dealing with it 10, 20, 30 years from now. And we don't have the leverage that we have then. So in some ways, I think it's really commendable and smart to be attacking this head on right now. How much are they hurting as a result?
China's hurting a great deal from it, and I think it will get worse. The problem is that the pain has not gotten bad enough for either side yet to force a deal. And I think that issue is very interesting about, well, maybe they're trying to wait it out and see if he loses re-election, they'll get a better deal with a stiff, as the president said. The issue there is, of course, first of all, there's a great chance he could get reelected, but you might argue better than 50%. I think everyone might have a different answer to that, but it's obviously very possible he'll be reelected. But I think the issue for our side, and I'm not trying to take the other side of it, but I'm just trying to point out his chances of getting reelected go up a lot the stronger the economy is. The longer this goes on and the more business investment here suffers, the more that potentially undermines some of the economic strength.
But you got the Fed on the back burner, KT. They're, you know, ready, willing, and able to lower rates. It looks like that's, in fact, what's going to happen. We'll see tomorrow. But if you can keep the U.S. economy going, and actually that's important. I agree, David, because, you know, U.S. voters, if they say, wait a second, like, we're really feeling the economic pain, they might not feel as confident about him. You know, in China, they don't have the ability to vote their guy out of office. So it's a different ball game. They can wait it out a little bit longer. So does the Fed help us enough with lower rates to ride this whole trade thing out?
I think that the polls are going to show 1 year from now exactly what they show now, which is that it's a 50-50 election. And I think that KT is probably right that China will try to drag it out at least till next summer. But I'd be very surprised if there's political clarity a year from now. We recall it was an election night surprise when President Trump beat Hillary. So I think this is going to be a close election. The issue I would come back to about the Fed that you brought up, businesses are not going to make long-term capital expenditures with uncertainty out there around a quarter point rate cut from the Fed that they know is transitory. Long term, this is what President Trump did so well when he first came into office. Deregulation, supply side, corporate tax cuts, repatriation, all of these things were giving businesses a lot of confidence. The data is pretty clear. Some of that's waning. The sooner a deal can get done, I think the more businesses put the pedal back down and you see manufacturing increase. That gets President Trump reelected.
Very quickly, China is increasingly suspicious of us, you know, for everything we saw, including, right, of me, as they went after me on their television network. But,
absolutely,
you know, right now they're blaming the United States for the Hong Kong protests. They say that we're the ones that are creating this chaos and the violence is all just directly a result of us. What do you say?
I do. I think what I would say is the United States is not behind this, but I sure wish they were, because I think what the protests are doing is excellent. It just so happens we're not behind any of it. She's right. It's complete paranoia from the Chinese government.
David, good to see you in-house. KT, thank you so much.